Have you got a print with some severe overhangs, and no matter what you're doing, it's just coming out icky poo, even supports isn't helping? Well, here's a couple of tricks that can turn your overhangs from being a nasty mess to being perfection. Overhangs are, along with bridging and orientation, some of the design principles that, if followed, will allow your FFF 3D prints to print without supports. I have an old video about that that you can watch in the cards here. I use these principles when designing my low poly dinos and other prints so that they will all print beautifully without supports. But if your overhangs are too far, if they go beyond the safe area for overhangs is about a 45 degrees from the vertical. If you go more than that, you're running into a danger zone. But we talk about it in degrees as far as the angle of the polygons go, but in reality, what we're talking about is the layer above stacking on top of the layer below, but having nothing below it when it does. And if it has too much, if it has to reach out too far, it could become a dangly, stringy mess. So how do we prevent that? Well, number one, more fan. Most 3D printers come with fans. And while I had to retrofit my old Replicator 1 with a fan because it was made in the days when we were printing in ABS and nobody thought about fans, nowadays almost every 3D printer has a fan that is pointed right at the nozzle. And the goal of the fan is to make it so that that plastic, as soon as it comes out of the nozzle, cools back down below its melt temperature and hardens. The faster you can get it to harden, then even as the print goes out over into the thin air, it will stay where it's supposed to be until it can anchor it back onto its own print. Now, obviously this doesn't work in prints where you're going out in 360 degrees. In those ones, just avoid high overhangs. But if there's a portion of the print that's going out and it's coming back, a lot more fan can help. Now, with this particular print, some of these overhangs came out looking really good, but then on the opposite side, the overhangs came out looking not as good. And why is that? Well, that's because the fan on this particular print was only coming in from one direction. So getting an additional fan, and I would recommend one that plugs in, not one that's battery powered, but whatever you can get, and pointing it on the other side of your print can sometimes help just adding that little bit of additional. However, that's not the biggest trick for making overhangs work. The biggest trick for making overhangs work is this one: lower layer heights. I know that if you make layer heights thinner, that your prints are going to take a lot longer, but take that time if you want your overhangs to look good, because a lower layer height means that you overhang less. Think about it. The thicker, chunkier layer has to cover more distance in the same degree of overhang as a thinner layer, and therefore the thinner layer doesn't have to go out physically as far as the thicker layer does. So thinner layers create much, much nicer overhang. So really, the big difference between this nasty print and this pretty good looking print was that I lowered my layer height between them, and that improved the overhangs dramatically. I hope that this has helped you, and it's going to help you in a future video, because I do want to show you what this corkscrew is for, so that's coming soon. Also coming soon is the Low Poly Dino Kickstarter, so if you haven't signed up for the mailing list, make sure that you do, because people on the mailing list who support the Kickstarter get an extra special gift, and that is coming soon. So, I want to thank you very much for watching. I hope that this helps. Big thanks to my Patreon backers. Your support is more needed than ever. You guys keep me afloat every month, and I appreciate it. And I want to say, remember safety first. I'll see you next time.